Hello friends. So friends, we are going to continue with our topic of ratio analysis, right? So under ratio analysis, in the last lecture we covered with the solvency ratios, and under the solvency ratios we covered the first of the solvency ratios, that is debt equity ratio. Debt equity ratio shows us the relationship between owner's funds and the borrowed funds, right? That is how much funds you have borrowed from the outsiders and how much is the owner's fund, right? So this is the debt equity ratio. Now in this lecture we are going to start with the second ratio under the solvency ratios only. The second ratio is total assets to debt ratio. Total assets to debt ratio. Now ratio is what? A relationship. So what we are going to study here, a relationship between the financial factors. Now can you tell me what are the two financial factors involved in this ratio? From the name itself you can identify. The financial factors are, one is total assets, right? The other one is debt, right? And when we talk about the solvency ratios, I told you we talk about only the long-term analysis. So here we will take only the long-term debt. Clear? We will consider only the long-term debt and not the current liabilities. Right? Now, what is the relevance of this asset to debt ratio? Total assets to debt ratio. Why we calculate this ratio? What is the usage of this ratio? Right? Now see, I'll take a very simple example. Mr. X, right? He has taken a loan from bank. He has taken a loan of rupees, say 50 lakhs. Loan of rupees 50 lakhs from bank. Now next, what happened? After some time, Mr. X could not repay loan. Right? That is, Mr. X is a defaulter. He couldn't repay this loan of 50 lakhs plus interest. He couldn't repay. Now, what will bank do? The bank has to recover the money somehow. What will bank do? Bank will try to sell various assets of Mr. X. How will bank recover the money? The bank will recover money by, he will try to sell the assets of Mr. X, obviously. Whatever assets he has a table, he has a chair, he has computers, he has generator sets. Whatever there are assets of Mr. X, the bank will sell those assets and try to recover as much money as they can of rupees 50 lakhs. Mr. X taken a loan of 50 lakhs. Mr. X became a defaulter. Now, what is the option with the bank? The bank has to recover some money. What will the bank do? Bank will apply his assets towards loan. That is, the bank will try to sell the various assets of Mr. X and try to recover as much money as possible. Right? Now the question is whether Mr. X has sufficient assets to recover a loan of 50 lakhs. whether Mr. X has sufficient assets which can recover a loan of rupees 50 lakhs. Right? So, what will bank do? For this, the bank will check its total assets to debt ratio. Right? The bank will try to assess what are the total assets of Mr. X against the debt that Mr. X has taken from the bank. Whether Mr. X has sufficient assets against the loan so that in case Mr. X is a defaulter, the bank is able to sell those assets and recover its money. Right? So consider Mr. X as a business. Right? So total assets to debt ratio is calculated to identify whether business has sufficient assets, right, against the long-term debt. Right? That is to cover the long-term debt, whether business has sufficient assets or not. So write this down. Total assets to debt ratio is calculated to identify whether the business has sufficient asset cover against its long-term debt. Long-term debt. See, if here Mr. X has the assets of say rupees 60 lakhs, so the bank will sell the assets and recover 50 lakhs plus whatever the interest is. So the bank is absolutely safe. But if here the Mr. X has the assets of say 30 lakhs, the bank is at a loss of 20 lakhs. So that is why it is important to identify the total assets to debt ratio of a business to identify whether business has sufficient asset cover for its long-term debts. Whether business has sufficient asset cover for its long-term debts. Clear? That is why this total assets to debt ratio is calculated. So what is the formula for this? Total assets to debt ratio. As the name suggests, total assets divided by long-term debt. We'll consider only the long-term debt. Clear? So, higher the ratio, better it is. Lower the ratio. If the ratio is lower, that means debt is more than the total assets, then the lenders are at risk. Right? If the business doesn't have the appropriate value of assets against the long-term debts, then the persons who have advanced these debts are at a risk. Clear? So higher the ratio, better it is, because they have the better safety margin. Clear? So this is why we calculate total assets to debt ratio to identify whether business has sufficient asset cover against its long-term debt so that in case of any default by the business, its assets can be applied to recover the debt money. Clear? Higher the ratio, better it is. Lower the ratio, the lenders are at risk. right? So total asset means non-current assets plus the current assets, everything. And the long-term debt means long-term borrowings and long-term provisions. Likewise, we calculated in the debt equity ratio. Clear? So friends, this is why we are calculating the total assets to debt ratio to identify whether business has sufficient asset cover against its long-term debt. It is a very useful ratio for the persons who have advanced money to the business. It is very important for them to know whether they are safe or whether they are at a very high risk situation. If the ratio is quite low, then they are at a high risk situation. In that case, the assets will be less than the long term debts. Clear? So let's do one practical problem on this. From the following information, calculate total assets to debt ratio. Capital employed 22,20,000, current liabilities 1,80,000, fixed assets gross 15 lakhs, accumulated depreciation of 2 lakhs, non-current investment 7 lakhs, trade receivables 2,50,000, equity share capital of 10,50,000, 8% debentures 3 lakhs, right? Capital reserve 2,40,000, surplus, that is balance in the statement of profit and loss 30,000, cash and cash equivalents 1,50,000, right? So now we need two things. We need the total assets and we need the long-term debts. Clear? So first of all, we'll calculate total assets, right? For this, we'll divide the total assets into two categories. One, we have non-current assets, and the other, we have current assets, right? Now, capital employed, it is an asset? No. Current liabilities? No. Fixed assets gross 15 lakhs? Yes, it is a non-current asset. Fixed asset gross, this is 15 lakhs, right? Next, accumulated depreciation of 2 lakhs, that means the accumulated depreciation on this fixed asset. It is a gross value given to us, not a net value. So what we will do? We will reduce the accumulated depreciation to reach at the actual figure of the fixed assets. What is the actual figure? Then non-current investments, 7 lakh. Right? Non-current investments clearly given. Investments, 7 lakh. Clear? Clear, friends? Now, what else you have? The next is trade receivables 2,50,000. It is a current asset. Trade receivables 2,50,000. Right? Equity share capital, no. 8% debentures, no. Capital reserve, no. Surplus, no. Cash and cash equivalents, 1,50,000. It is a current asset. Cash, 1,50,000. Now, what is the total? 13,720 lakhs of the non-current assets and 4 lakh of current assets. So, the total assets are 24 lakhs. Clear? Now, what is the next information? We need to calculate the long-term debts. Now, if you see at the question, you will say there are 8% debentures, which is a long-term debt. So we'll consider this 3 lakh only, right? But be careful, we are given the capital employed also. We are given the equity share capital also, right? We are given capital reserve also. We are given surplus in the balance also. Why I'm telling you these things, there is a relationship between all these things. You will not consider only 8% debentures, but we will calculate the long-term debt. Now, what is the relevance of giving this capital employed? What is the relevance of giving this capital employed? This capital employed means the total money invested in the business. Total money invested in the business. Total money means owner's funds and borrowed funds. Then I told you, what are owner's funds called? It is called equity. And borrowed funds are known as debts, right? Equity includes two parts: equity share capital and reserves and surplus, right? Now, if you see the question, what is given? See the question, you are given capital employed, you are given equity share capital, you are given capital reserve, you are given the surplus, right? So what is the information that you have? You have equity shares, you have reserves, you have surplus, you have capital employed. So you can calculate the borrowed funds or the debt, isn't it? You can calculate the borrowed funds or the debt. First of all, write down capital employed is equal to shareholders funds plus long-term debt. What is capital employed? Capital employed is 22,20,000. What is shareholders fund? Shareholders fund means equity. Equity means equity shares plus reserves and surplus. We have equity share capital of 10,50,000. Right? So I'll write 10,50,000 plus reserves of 2,40,000 and surplus of 30,000 is a loss. So the loss will be subtracted, plus 2,40,000 minus 30,000 loss, right? Plus the long term debt. Now you can calculate the long term debt of 22,20,000 minus 10,50,000 minus 2,40,000 plus 30,000. Simple mathematics. This comes to rupees 9,60,000. Right? This 8% debentures, which is again a long-term debt, is given to confuse you. Right? One hand, it is given capital employed. On the other hand, it is given this information. This is just to confuse you. The actual long-term debt is 9,60,000. This 3 lakh of debentures is included in this 9,60,000. Right? This debentures of 3 lakh is included in the long-term debts of 9,60,000. The figure of 8% debentures is given to confuse you, because we are given capital employed, we are given the shareholders' funds. We should calculate the long-term debt. So be careful while doing such questions, right? So you have the long-term debt of 9,60,000 now, and what are the assets? 24 lakhs. So now you can calculate total asset to debt ratio. This is total assets divided by long-term debts. Total assets of 24 lakhs and the long-term debt of 9,60,000. This comes to 2.5:1. This means that you have the sufficient asset cover for the debts. If you have 100 rupees to be paid to the outsider, you have 250 rupees in your pocket. That means you have 150 rupees extra, which is a sufficient cover for an outsider. You have to pay someone 100 rupees and you have 250 rupees in your pocket. This is a good ratio for the business. Higher the ratio, better it is. Lower the ratio, the lenders are at a very high risk. Clear? Clear, friends? Just be careful with this type of questions where you have the capital employed, right? Capital employed is total money invested in the business. Total money means owner's fund and the borrowed funds. Owner's fund is equity, right? Equity means equity shares and reserves and surplus. This is also known as shareholders' funds. Then we have the borrowed funds, right? So from here we can calculate the long-term debt. In this long-term debt of 9,60,000, 3,08 debentures, 8% debentures are also covered. Clear? So friends, this is how we use total assets to debt ratio. Clear? This is all about the total assets to debt ratio. So friends, in the next lecture, we'll move on to the next solvency ratio, that is proprietary ratio. Right? So we'll discuss about the proprietary ratio. If you have any queries, just send me an email at ksjteaching@gmail.com. Right? So that's all for this lecture, friends. Thank you so much.